Me.
Oh,
I'm doing a YouTube. I've got my own YouTube.
Oh, no way. What are you doing? What's the channel about?
Love thy neighbor. Walk up and say, how be ya? Gee, but I'm glad to see your pal. How's tricks? What's new? Love thy neighbor. Offer to share his burden. Tell him to say the word and you'll see him through. Especially if there should be a beautiful girl next door. Say to the girl next door, don't think I'm bold. My mother told me to love thy neighbor, and you will find your labor a great deal easier. Life will be breezier if you love thy neighbor. If there should be a beautiful girl next door, say to the girl next door, don't think I'm bold. My mother told me to love thy neighbor, and you will find your labor a great deal easier. Life will be breezier if you love thy neighbor.
One last time. I just got to do that, you know. But it's okay, it's okay. It's okay. Okay, I'm going to go back. I'm going to head the other way. We all know who lives there now. You don't need to go to the door and open the door. We all know. This guy's gonna turn right round. Gonna turn around and get me. So here we go, look. Just done a bit of driving around this morning. I think today is really easy to get around. Really easy to get around for a weekend, for a Saturday. And I don't know the reason why. I think it's maybe everybody's waiting at home for some new rules. I really don't know. You know, look, you just do what you really got to do. You don't worry about anything. It's just, I think people are just wondering what's coming. You know. I'll tell you what's coming. Love thy neighbour. That's what's coming. Be strong and love your family. And yeah, everything's going to be good. The sun's going to be shining again. And it always will. So whatever happens, it's good over evil. You just have to remember all the things that we've done before. And keep going because if you don't keep going and you just stop and you wonder what to do next, that might bring in a few problems. But just keep going, don't look back, try not to look back, and be strong, you know. But anyway, this is coming to the end now. So now the thing I wanted to say, here's the thing I wanted to say. So I was at this cafe this morning. It's just an example. I was at a cafe this morning, and I'm on the same road, by the way. This is Auburn Road, just in case you wasn't sure. But I'm on Auburn Road, and you just saw those houses that were on Love Thy Neighbour in Australia again. I took you through on episode one, and I just showed you. I just had someone just stop me for a moment and said, "Hey, what are you doing? I'm not filming you. I'm filming me." It's me. So I just was in a cafe, and you know, just minding my own business, having something, you know, having your own something to eat. And there's a couple across from me, an older man and an older woman. And the girl put the food on the table and just asked for some more assistance. And the man's face is angry. I think he was ready to explode to her. She's only young, you know. You don't need it. These people that think they've got so much money and put themselves on pedestals. Nah, sorry. No, you can just stop there. These young ones, these kids now that we have, and the new generation have got to be looked after. You can't just treat them like that, because you know, one might be bigger than another. It doesn't make any sense at all. You can't put yourself up there, because you've got, you know, some people have got so much money and they think they're the kings, and that doesn't make any difference at all. Everybody has to treat everybody equally, and that's all bullshit, whatever's going on out there, because I've seen it, you know, whatever's happening out there and how people are being treated is wrong, you know. In a way, you've got to put yourself like in Eddie Booth's shoes, you know. You've got to be smart to catch an Eddie Booth in the morning, or any Booth in the morning. And if you want to ask me what time to get up in the morning, I don't know, probably about 4 o'clock, I don't know. But anyway, that's just a little thought, you know, today. So, where are we heading now to the last few episodes? So this one, basically, I'm asking people here. It's usually elderly, but there's not many. I can stop this guy on a bike, maybe, and see if he knows Love Thy Neighbour. There's not many people. And if I do come across that fella that came through on the first or second episode, I'll give him a DVD box set if he's got a DVD player.
Oh, where are you going?
There's someone coming down here with a bike, so hang on.
Yeah, how are you?
Yeah, good. Do you mind me asking you, do you remember a TV show called Love Thy Neighbour?
Love Thy Neighbour,
TV show.
I'm not too sure, because I watch your TV a lot.
Many years ago, yeah. 1980, thereabouts.
Say it again in our words.
Love Thy Neighbour. It's a white family, and then the black family next door.
I remember.
It's coming back slowly, yeah? It's an English show, funny comedy.
Come back again. I heard something on TV, come back. Sometimes it's too many shots, too many. Good, man. Thank you for that.
Yeah, just a reminder. Oh.
Yeah, it's good.
Take care, take it easy.
Welcome, my friend. See you
later. Bye-bye. See, a few people down here can recall it, you know. I'm just driving, you know, having to drive down here and ask a few people. They do have, or can recall, watching the TV show or bringing back the memory slowly, because what's been happening in the past few years, everybody's tried to forget. No, not really tried to forget, but I think things have been forgotten, and you don't want to forget these things, you know, these people that have brought us the fun in life, you know. And Jack Smethurst, Rudolph Walker, Keith Marsh. I'm trying to remember the names. So that was pretty good, I must admit, because I've been trying to look up the names of the past few weeks. Tommy Godfrey. I remember Tommy Godfrey when I mentioned that in the first episode, because he's a laugh and a half, and he's got a real strong, broad London accent, you know, very funny, very funny. And this is where, I don't know if you remember, this is where I met one of the guys and I was looking for the number. And when he said love thy neighbor, and he just lit up like anything. So yeah, there's a few people, you know, but I've got to stop them, you see. And if it's young people, they won't know, you know. If I say, oh, do you know love thy neighbor to someone young, they just got no idea, you know. They haven't seen it. They didn't live that those years. So it's not much activity down here. But when I go towards the shops, there's more and more people down there I can ask. Now, if you remember that last episode, when I was here last time, when I was around the area, I wasn't down back there then. And I asked someone, do you remember Love Thy Neighbour? His English wasn't good. So he could have been, I think it was a Middle Eastern background, and he could well have been Turkish. What looked to me, he looked like a Turkish guy, but I can't speak the language, so I'm not very good. So I tried to communicate to him and asked him, do you remember Love Thy Neighbour? And then I said, no. He goes, no. And then I said, Channel 7. He goes, Channel 7? Yeah, yeah, he knows Channel 7. but when he said Channel 7, he said mosque. So he's probably thinking, I'm looking for a mosque to go and pray or something. So, yeah, so that's, yeah, he understood Channel 7, and he probably was thinking, oh, I've seen something on Channel 7, maybe something in Auburn, and then he said mosque. So that's probably what he's thinking. So, no, I understand his thoughts. It's just that he didn't know Love Thy Neighbour, but if he saw it on TV, I'm sure he'd know. He's old enough to know. Sure, old enough and living here for a long time, I'm sure. But yeah, the activity down here, everybody's just either indoors, they've gone away somewhere. Yeah. So it's just a quiet Saturday today. Probably people shopping. Yeah, you know, I don't want to stop people. But let me just have a look to see if there's any more I can ask. I mentioned to somebody that's probably about the same age as me or a little bit younger. I mentioned, you know, things like the Carry On films, and then I said Love Thy Neighbour, and his face lit up, and he goes, oh, I remember that one, you know. And he remembers thinking it was very funny, you know, a very funny show. And so I think he's actually gone to mention it to other people, so the word is spreading. Love thy neighbour. Spread the word. Because, you know, today you need that. Today you need to spread those words, make people happy. You know, the families have got to be more closer than ever now. But let me just try and get down to the centre of Auburn and see again. Because today it's not as busy as it should be, but you know, I know you want it to go forever. So do I actually really want this to go forever. I could walk this street up and down 100 times, you know, but I don't think that's gonna happen. Oh, it's not the greatest looking place in the world. On driving in here, seeing all these cranes up all over the place. Apartments on one side and some houses on the other side. And I'm sure those people in the houses are thinking, oh, I used to have a really good view. Now I've got a view of the apartments. Okay, so, yeah, where are we now? We're just heading up to the petrol station. And on the other side is the, I think one of the schools. I'm not sure if it's still open now, I don't know. So, I mean, not today, but where are they still in operation? I'm pretty sure they are, you know. Then you got all the apartments down there. Northumberland Street and the station, I think you have to go further down. So it will take up the whole episode if I was just to record me walking all the way down there. It's just pointless, really. I can walk halfway. I can walk halfway. Yes. I can walk halfway and then I have to stop, see? In the middle of the road now. So here I am back again. I'll see, there's a car over there doing a... You just see a car over there, a blue one. He just did a, went over the double white lines. You're not supposed to do that. Some people turn around. Now, I've seen some really odd things happening now. It never used to happen before. But because these people were coming in and using their driver's license illegally, they can think they do anything they want. So they drive around, they see those two white lines. You're not supposed to go, oh well, you can go around, you're not supposed to. But what they're doing is, they decide, oh, I've gone the wrong way. I'm not gonna go around the roundabout, I'm gonna just turn here. So they just do it that way. Oh, let them do it. Yeah, just do what you wanna do. One day someone's gonna stop you and realize what you did wrong. He's turning left, apparently, but he's actually... So, you know, all these little mistakes... I see all these mistakes happening in, as I get older and older. I pay attention to a lot of things. You know, I hear lots of conversations in the distance. You know, if someone says something about someone else, I know, you know, and you hear these horns going off for no apparent reason, you know... And that's happening now. It's just crazy. And I mean, you know, bring Eddie Booth here, seriously. Bring him here. He'll see what's going on. He'll blow your mind. Because he knows what's going on here. It's not right. Nothing, is it? There's nothing right about anything really anymore. But you try to make everything good. Okay. Keep going then. Let's have a look. I didn't record. So I didn't record just now. But I'll tell you the conversation. I just stopped a moment ago and just recorded. And I didn't want to, you know, put the camera in the woman's face. She's probably about my age or older. And I said to her, do you mind me asking, do you know... Or can you recall a TV show called Love Thy Neighbour? And she goes, oh, vaguely remember it, yes. And she didn't light up so much, but she does remember it. And then she said, I do remember it. And I said, well, there was an Australian version of it, 7 episodes. And I said, it was recorded down there. And she goes, oh, I didn't know that. And I said, yeah, that's... And I said, I just thought I'd ask. And look, thanks, you know, just said that and have a good day. And that was it. So there's few people that do recall that, you know, you can go around and ask if you want. I mean, it's not a silly thing. What's wrong with Love Thy Neighbour? Really? I'm not being racist either. So that was an Australian person I asked. No, I can go up to anybody, you know, and I can ask the same thing. I tell you what amazes me is the work that goes on the weekends as well. The amount of work that goes on the weekends, like, you know, construction and everything like that, is still happening on the weekends. So besides the Monday to Friday work, is, you know, they're all, everybody's making a lot of money. There's a lot of people in this business making a lot of money. Except for me, I'm just sitting here recording YouTube. 1,000 subscribers this week. 1,000. Thanks for your help. And looking at, what the date, what's the date? 20th of May. 20th of May, I've reached 1,000. I've never done that, so yeah, thanks. It'd be good if there's more, but I don't know how I can get any more. Okay, I'm just walking past the, there's a majority of, so around here you got tobacconists, money transfer places, a couple of $2 shops, you know, like, there's a few, if you want to cut your hair, you can. I didn't do it here though. besides 100,000, you know, if you want to get your arms fixed or something else, or if you've got problems with your eyes, mate, it's all here. You can, that's how they're making their money. They're all making their money.
They did for my Uncle Charlie, you know.
Who did?
Hospitals. If he ever had to go into hospital, he'd have been here today. Killed him, you know.
Hospitals are supposed to cure people.
That's just the point, love. There was nothing wrong with him. You see, he'd been complaining of dizziness and difficulty with breathing. So they took him in for 10 days observation. They shoved things in him, up him, down him. Anywhere they could, they shoved something.
Did they diagnose what was wrong with him?
No. It baffled them. It was my Auntie Nellie who found out what was wrong with him. He'd been wearing a shirt collars a size too small.
Don't believe a word of it.
It's true, love, it's true. She got him a larger size and he was discharged as being cured.
Just a minute. You said hospitals killed him.
They did. On his way out, he was knocked down by an ambulance.
A few little jewellery shops here and there. But other than that, that's it. That's it. And the migration centres. You know about that already. It's all happening. You ask these people behind me or up here, you know, have you ever watched it? Oh, no. You need to stop someone that...
Hello. Can I ask you a question? It's okay. Do you remember a TV show, Love Thy Neighbour? Love Thy Neighbour?
Nah. Sometimes it doesn't work. Yeah, 50% off. Ooh, no, what else is not? Turkish Airlines. Oh yeah.
Welcome to Classic Gifts and Homewares, where you'll never have to pay the full price again.
Never pay the full price again, but you're paying through the nose for everything else anyway. It's okay. I'm okay. I've had my food. I'm not gonna get a kebab for the third time. Yeah, we could have one last beer. Club Auburn's right down there. So it's all within the facility, you know. And that's Auburn Hotel. We've been there before. I took you there before, as you know. Club Auburn, how many times? I've been there a couple of times already. So that means Northumberland Road is up there. You can take you there one last time through it, you know. This is the final episode that you're going to see me in, pretty much, because the next ones that you see will be kind of a compilation of what I've done. Bringing it to a bit of a sad ending, I guess. Oh. See, the kids love these things. See? the little cakes and the drinks.
The place to go to here, like, this is one place, like, on a during the week, Thursday night or something, but Cabramatta's good too. So people love that area, and it's more, you got more of your, we've been past this, remember? You got more of your, you got the Chinese, Vietnamese, Korean community all going to that area for the food, because they love the food around there. So that's a good place to be. I found out about this kebab place, Star Kebabs, because they say it's 5-star and it's probably one of the best kebabs around the area. I found out from, I think it's some Korean woman on YouTube. Yeah, so I found out that way, so. Yeah, so there's a toy shop here. And 5-stars. So it's all around the area.
Excuse me. Sorry, do you mind me asking? Do you remember a TV show called Love Thy Neighbour?
I never heard of it.
An old English show. Funny comedy. No? Okay, that's okay. Yeah. Now, I just thought I'd ask you to see if you remember, because it's a memory going back from 70s, 80s.
Oh.
And I'm older now, so I thought I'd ask you. And it's recorded in Auburn.
In Auburn?
Yeah. So the last series was recorded in Auburn. It's okay. It's a long time ago now. Yeah. So no worries. All the best. No. I'm not saying you. No, not at all. All the best. Take care.
That kebab's tempting, but I'd right now would prefer a beer. I don't know if you heard that, but some people have not much memory of Love Thy Neighbour. But if I keep going in one episode and doing it, it'll be surprising, you know, the amount of people that would just say, oh yeah. But I just have to stop there, I think. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to get a drink. Some places, like, before you walk into the place, I think, oh no, hang on a minute. Let me just think about what I'm doing here. I'm going to buy something. I like to buy it from someone who respects you, you know. But not these places that don't put prices on, or you don't know how much you're paying. And then they say $100. Yeah, $100 for a coffee. Okay, yeah, I'll buy that. Yeah. You think I'm going to buy a $100 coffee? I'll go to the airport if I want to do that. So I'm just walking to the car now, because I know, I think I want to go back to... And it was so far away. It was so far off, it didn't even need to do it. So to be honest, I just ignore all that. When I'm driving, I just ignore. The other day I had a big truck, and I passed the white line a little bit, but he could get through anyway, you know, that's no problem. But his reaction was, and I thought, yeah. I passed the white line, but I'm still at the traffic lights anyway, so I know what I'm doing. Doesn't mean I'm gonna hit him. I just think all the kids need to be looked after. I realised that when I was working in retail for a long time. I wouldn't do it anymore. Especially standing up all day, trying to help people, but, you know, and some people, you know, you're not ripping them off. Sometimes they're tricking you, but I'm not saying the customers do that to you, but you get the odd one or two people that just, of course, they ask you questions, and then they ask for questions, and then they buy from online. They don't want to buy from you at all. So when I learned about the children, and, you know, looking when I was working in retail, it was like every few weeks I'd see it. You know, like some people, parents, leaving their children, you know, and they don't look after them like they should. And look, and that really, that shows, it just shows you how, it's really hard to say it really. Depends on how you bring your child up, you know. When I said to you before I hadn't had the time to do this show, yes, yeah, I had the time. It's just to actually get round to bringing you this show. But you've got other priorities in life, you know. And your priorities are your family, you know. And when I'm at the at the job before, when I was at the job before, and you know, when I used to see a crying little girl coming up to me, mum, I'm the one going up there and saying, "Have you lost your mum?" And where are the mums and dads gone? No, they don't care. They're looking for their TV or fridges or whatever. They don't care about their kids. So they should. And that's the number one priority today. Is my message is, look after your family, look after the children. And if you, for 1 minute, take your eyes off your children, that's the number one priority right now. I've got lots of messages. Oh yeah, I was here once. I was doing my messages here.
Yeah.
Number 93. I know exactly where we're going now. So I'll go back to the car. Sweet shop. If you want to look after your kids, sweet shop, but in moderation, in moderation, not too much. No bubble gums, no hardboard sweets every few days. Going back in the 70s, and other families would know this, if you had four or five children, you know, the mums used to get the sweets, and if they were hard done by during that week, and they didn't have much money, but they had maybe one or two hard-boiled sweets, they'll share it amongst the children. So they get the big knife and cut it in half. That's the way it was. That's the way it was then. So the majority of people have got money today, but then the majority of people are not sleeping in houses or their own homes anymore. It's tents, you know, it's different. It's a different story today. All those things people complaining about today, and it's one after the other, mate. That's not a language I know, and that's not a language I'll bring up. I'll just stop there and won't say anything, because I don't believe in anything like that. If they want to talk some other language to me, good luck. But I think you know what I mean. Episode 18 is this one, is this episode. I've made a few episodes that I've mixed, and almost made a few errors, and almost fatal errors, but I had to fix them up. So I had to give you some rundowns of the airport before even going there. Oh, actually, I went there, and then I had to make an episode. It's like pre-recorded, you could say. So a bit confusing, I know, but I had to bring these episodes to you in this order, in this type of order. I was meant to I think I recorded it on one episode, but I hadn't put it out for reasons that, you know, 30 minutes is very limited time as well. I need to thank Russell Newman for at least just given me the opportunity to get a little bit closer. You know, it's not easy trying to get everyone together, and you know, to you know, speak. To speak about this show, you know, it's not an easy thing. But I did mention it's going to be a fun thing, and you know, and not long, just a short video, and just having all the others there to talk with too would be good. If it's not possible, I do understand. Because some things, you know, can be. Oh, look at this! I haven't seen many people today down this road, and you know, I don't feel that I want to get the opportunity to do it. You know, I had a feeling, a buzzing feeling the other day, thinking, oh yes, I really want to go and ask this person. But I don't see those type of people down here that I can ask, that can remember Love Thy Neighbour. And you can kind of tell that they may have seen it before, or they've lived here a long time. Yeah, it's different today. It's just, people are away from their own areas, I think. Busy with their own lives, doing other things. Hardly a car on the road. I mean, I came here, yeah, and I went to the place that I was meant to be going to, on the North Shore, and I made it within, you know, 20 minutes. It's phenomenal. I've never been like that, in a situation like that before. Traffic is just, when I mean incredible, I mean, there isn't much. That can mean a few things. You know, here's something I didn't mention, but today, up to today, I've not even found the house. I mean, to actually look for a house and its design, it's not an easy thing, but this house. But you'll see what I mean when we come to the final show. Yeah, you see what I mean. I didn't find the house, just one house. And it's, yeah, very hard. Very hard job. Looking up and down this way as well, not easy. But anyway, once again, this is it. Oh, it's okay, you just, when you want one, it's okay, you only want one, and that's, got one, I've got one anyway.
Where's my beer?
Well, it went flat, so we drank it.
At our beach.
Very nice of you, thanks a bunch.
It's not your night, is it?
It's all Sambo's fault.
Watch it, Paleface.
Oh, knickers.
You're only jealous because I've got a car, you know.
And what's so special about having a car?
The fact that you haven't got one.
I could have a car if I wanted to. Fact is, I don't believe in them. They're a menace. Could be abolished.
But you can't abolish cars. How would people get about, eh?
Simple. Bring back the horse.
Oh, man, you're crazy.
I am not. Horses are more reliable than cars.
Prove it.
Well, for a start, You don't have to have them serviced every 1,000 miles. And if a car runs out of petrol, you've had it. I mean, you've never heard of a horse stopping because it run out of oats.
Man, that is the most stupid idea I've ever heard.
Anyway, horses don't pollute the atmosphere.
You joking? You get a few hundred horses jammed on the North Circular for a couple of miles and you're polluted right up the M1.
You've got a point there, Eddie.
See you, fellas.
Yeah.
Money, 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 share the wealth.
I had to get the same thing again, didn't I? Cheers. So what I thought was going to be one episode turned out to be just more than one. I didn't think it's going to be like something like 20. But see, one led to another, and I had to do these investigations, you see, and just to make me happy and to make the audience happy. I think the thing, though, there is another thing, and I know many of you wanted me to, you know, go to the house and see who's living there now and that sort of thing, but we've got a good idea. And but the main thing with this is we've found the locations, and we've done all the investigation that we had to do. We've kind of located pretty much all of the locations of where Jack Smethurst was when he was here, so, or as close as possible. And yeah, that's all really. So I hope you've enjoyed this series as much as I have been doing it. Well, this is it really. So there's this episode. There's like it's kind of a catch-up episode, which is the next one. The catch-up episode is probably the things that you've missed, you know, on the first episodes, and, you know, it's like a catch-up type of thing. So if you want to see all the other episodes all in one, you can see that, you know, I've kind of tried to put those together. And then that's the next one. And then, of course, a bit of a surprise is the last episode, episode 20. I hope that once again, thank you for subscribing, for those people that did, and for those that have watched, thank you. You know, I mean, every person counts trying to watch this. So, and for those that have been involved in this video, and some haven't noticed, but thank you. And for those that helped with these videos, it's been really good. So thank you to those people. Yeah, has been really good and enjoyable, and we've got another adventure coming up soon, probably a short one. Yeah, this one's towards its end, so hope you've enjoyed this one. So next one is a catch-up one, like a catch-up episode, and then the final one is the locations. So thanks for watching. This is it, guys. This is, let's do it again. This is it, guys. The conclusion of Love Thy Neighbour. And stuck here. Poof. Yeah. This is it. Here it is. This is it. Conclusion of the investigation. This is the conclusion. This is the conclusion of the investigation of Jack Smethurst in Australia. This is it, guys. This is the conclusion of the investigation of Jack Smethurst in Love Thy Neighbour in Australia 2023. And this is the end. We've come to the end. Come to the end. Here we go.